Hi everybody, this is Flavia and I appreciate you watching this video. Today, I will be showing you some products that I purchased from Spellbinders in April during their spring sales. I actually meant to release this video for you earlier, however, I am only now finding the time to create some note cards with these products and edit this video, so I hope you still enjoy it. I love Spellbinders spring sales because we can get really great deals and I am very pleased with the products that I purchased. In this video, I will give you a closer look at each one of the products that I got, and I will also have lots of note card examples so you can have a better idea of how they work and the great results that we can get. Just in case you're interested in purchasing some of them, I will have everything listed in the description box down below if they are still available, so you don't have to worry about that as you're watching this video. I will begin with the Head in the Cloud embossing folder. This one measures 4.25 by 5.5 inches, so it is perfect for A2 size note cards. I like having embossing folders as well as metal plates for creating basic elements such as clouds, stars, snowflakes, flowers, and hearts because it allows us to create different scenes and use them to make note cards for different occasions. These puffy clouds are exactly what I needed, and I actually used this panel on a note card that I will show you in a minute. Next, we have this gorgeous Starburst Glimmer Hot Foil Plate. I absolutely love this one. It adds stunning foil accents and it is also a great plate for doing the reverse foiling technique. This metal plate is about 4.5 by 5.75 inches, so perfect for A2 size note cards. Actually, we can create even bigger panels with this plate by simply shifting the plate and hot foiling it a second time on the other half of the panel if you need to. And here we have another set, which is the Just Wanted to Say Glimmer Hot Foil Plates. It comes with 8 plates with sentiments for many different occasions which I like, such as have a wonderful birthday, congratulations, and thanks for all you do. Unfortunately, this one is not available anymore, but know that Spellbinders has lots of sentiment hot foil plates similar to this one if you're interested. Moving on, here we have the Be Bold Color Block Congrats die set. This set comes with 2 metal plates, this large one to cut out the word congrats and the small one for the yay that we can place on top. This set is perfect for creating mini slimline note cards. I don't really own a lot of graduation stamps and die sets, so I just had to get this one. I really like this set because it allows us to quickly create graduation note cards, and we can even mass produce by cutting all of the letters at once, using different colors of cardstock and mixing and matching the colors to create note cards with different color combinations. Here are all of the graduation note cards that I created using this set. To add some sparkle to these graduation note cards, I added star sequins and I stacked a few yay die cuts so it stands out nicely since it is so small when compared to this large die cut congrats. Next, we have this adorable Dancing Ghost die set, which is just perfect for Halloween. The legs of the die-cut ghost move from side to side, creating a really fun surprise for the recipient. This set includes metal plates to cut out a treat container, candy, and a sentiment. It was very easy to assemble the pieces, and here is an example for you. I only made one note card, but I can't wait to create many more using this set. We do need to use foam adhesive when adhering the ghost to the front panel of the note card, and also to make sure that nothing touches the legs so we can freely move. The next set that I have is the Dancing Santnik. This die set comes with 9 metal plates to cut out elements to create an adorable Santa with moving legs, just like the Dancing Ghost that I just showed you. For this note card that I created, I used the Starburst Glimmer Hot Foil Plate that I showed you at the beginning of the video to decorate the flap of my envelope and to create this wonderful background panel. And as I mentioned before, the Starburst Glimmer Hot Foil Plate is perfect for the reverse foiling technique. First, I used a golden foil by Spellbinders, and on the flap of the envelope, I used the metal plate as it was intended for. However, for this panel on the right, after I created the foil background panel for my note card, I used the leftover foil piece here, along with a square-shaped plate that is meant to be used to do the reverse foiling technique. This way, nothing went to waste, and I ended up with two beautiful hot foiled panels. For the second set of panels, I used a piece of silver holographic speckled foil, also by Spellbinders. And again on the right, we have the result of the reverse foiling technique, which means I used the leftover foil piece from the panel on the left. And since I just can't get enough of these adorable characters, here is another one. This is the floating bunny die set that also allows us to create a bunny with an interactive element. This set was released as the small die of the month for March 2022, and believe it or not, it was still available for purchase in 2023. I was able to resist it when Spellbinders first released the set, and also when I saw Yannis Makula creating beautiful note cards with this set. However, since I still cannot get over how adorable this is, I just had to buy it before it was too late. This set includes 14 metal plates to create a bunny on a swing or a bunny holding balloons in different shapes. It also comes with plates to cut out the sentiments swinging to spring, which by the way is very appropriate for this set. Here are the two note cards that I created using the floating bunny die set, and I absolutely love these cuties. For this first note card, I used that cloud embossing folder that I showed you at the beginning of the video, just to add some interest to the background. The bunny in the swing, of course, can swing from side to side, and these die-cut clouds on the top are actually hiding the interactive mechanism that allows this bunny to swing. I used silver glitter cardstock to cut out the sentiment, so it has a lot of sparkle in person, and I added some small die-cut flowers that I already had around to decorate this front panel. To make it extra sweet, I added a small die-cut heart to his body, and notice how its tiny hands are actually holding the swing. How adorable is that? Seriously, I just can't. I smile every time I look at this note card, and I just want to make one for every person that I see. For this second note card, I used that same cloud panel, but this time I decided to add some color by ink blending over the clouds with light blue ink. Here the bunny is holding three large balloons that swing from side to side, and these three balloons are hiding the interactive mechanism. By the way, to make these balloons glossy, I just apply Ranger Glossy Accents. For the sentiment, I just added a foiled sentiment strip that I already had around, so I could turn this into a birthday note card. Since die cutting and assembling die cuts is my favorite technique, most of the products that I purchase are die sets, and this next one that I have to show you is the special pet delivery. Just like the previous set, I have been dreaming about this one for a while and trying to resist it for as long as I could until spring sales came. There are 15 metal plates included in this set, so we can create either a cat or a puppy that is peeking out of a window, which is just adorable, and I know that I will be creating many note cards with this set. Before I show you some card examples, let me go ahead and show you another die set that I got, which is this surprise box. I really wanted to get this set so that I could use it with the special pet delivery die set. This way, I can have puppies or cats peeking out of a delivery box. With this surprise box, we can actually create dimensional open boxes, which is really cool. I also want to show you this coordinating stamp set called Santa Paws Sentiments, which we can use to stamp on the die-cut boxes. So here is the story about this stamp set. A long time ago, maybe last year, I made to purchase all of these three sets, but for whatever reason, I only added this stamp set to my shopping cart, which was so annoying. I think that I believe that I was buying everything in a bundle for whatever reason by only placing the stamp set in my cart. That means I actually have been holding on to this stamp set for a while, waiting for the right moment to purchase the other two sets so I can use them all together. So I'm very glad that 2023 spring sales finally came and that I was lucky enough to still find the sets available. Here we have the two note cards that I created. This first one has a cat peeking out of a brown box. To decorate this brown box, I used two of the stamps included in the Santa Paws Sentiments stamp set. I also stamped a sentiment inside the note card, and notice that I used that Starburst Glimmer Hot Foil plate again to add some interest to the background. However, this time, instead of gold or silver, I used a piece of foil in the color Opal, which is very subtle and adds just enough interest without taking too much from the focal point of this note card, which is the brown box with the cat inside. And for the second note card, I have a cute puppy peeking out of a window, and notice that I used the leftover piece of the opal foil from the previous note card to do the reverse foiling technique for this front panel. So, while the previous note card has a white panel with opal foiled starburst, the second one has an opal foiled panel with white starburst. I really enjoy this technique because not a single piece of foil goes to waste. And again, because the opal foil is so light, it doesn't take a lot from the focal point of this note card either. This note card is A2 size and it has a surprise window, which means that when it is closed, it looks like everything that we can see is glued to the front panel. However, when we open the note card, we can see that the puppy is actually glued to the inside of the note card. Moving on to the last product that I got, here we have the Flowering Tree Sentiment die set that is meant to be used with another set that I already have and use a lot, which is the Flowering Tree and Collapsible Card Base that was released in March 2023 as the large die of the month. This large set comes with 16 metal plates to create a beautiful pop-up blooming tree. This set actually comes with a sentiment metal plate to cut out the words Happy Birthday, and by purchasing this other metal plate set that I can use to cut out the sentiment Thank You, I will be able to make the most out of this flowering tree and collapsible card base set by creating note cards for another occasion. Here is a card example featuring these two sets. As we can see, we can easily fold this pop-up tree flat to place it inside an A2 size envelope. And when the recipient takes it out, it pops up and stands nicely on display. In the back, I added a small note card to write a personal message. So these are all of the products that I got, and I hope you enjoyed this video and felt inspired. And if you are thinking about purchasing some of these products, I hope this video was helpful to you. As always, thank you so much for spending this time with me and helping this channel grow. I really appreciate it. I hope you have a wonderful day. Take care and see you again soon.